moving on now to our GMA Parenting Alert. And with the school year winding down, that means summer camp for so many kids. One of our parenting experts, Rachel Simmons, here to talk about kids in camp. And we've had a lot of experience with this in our house. I have one of each at home. Elliot hated camp. Harper absolutely loves it. We made them both try it. But in each case, after that first week, they said, get me out of here.
Absolutely.
How do you know when you should stick with it and when to pull back?
Well, I think we have to remember, no matter what, camp is this amazing opportunity for our kids to develop resilience and self-sufficiency. And when they call us, it's like they dump the worst of their feeling on us. And so that's a moment where we've got some tips for you here. We really think it's important for you to call the camp and check in. Because for all you know, your kid's crying on the phone, but having a great day otherwise. So you can't just rely on their perspective. You also, I don't know how you felt when you heard them upset or when you heard,
oh my gosh,
right? You're freaking out, yeah, and you want to just yank her because you, as the parent, your job is to try to fix her problems. But that's the moment where you have to ask yourself, is it worth it to let her be uncomfortable so that she can show herself that she's confident enough to survive and not let your fears get confused
and
with
so
hers?
And so much goes into picking the right camp as well, because some camps are better than others, and knowing this, knowing how to handle kids, knowing that this is something that will pass.
Absolutely. And one of the things we can do with our kids is just help them brainstorm strategies to deal with problems before they go to camp. You don't want to tell them it's going to be bad, but you can say, look, it's an uncertain situation. Challenges may arise. Let's talk now about what you're going to do when you get homesick or if you don't fit into the friend group you want to that first minute that you get there.
And how about those for those whose camp just isn't their thing, isn't what they're supposed to be doing? When they come home, how do you make them not feel like a failure?
Right. So it's so important for us to remind our kids that failure is part of learning. It is a feature of learning. It's not a bug of learning. And all you have to do, it doesn't help your kid to beat themselves up, or for you as the parent for that matter. What matters is getting back out there, trying new things, and making sure you tell your kid that it's a muscle you have to flex, you have to keep trying, and that's what's going to make you tough, not giving up and beating yourself up.
But also
up.
Listening to them and what they really like, what they really respond
sure,
to.
Sure, empathy is key. I mean, we may want our kid to do all kinds of things, but if we're not listening to them, they're going to end up making choices that don't serve them in the end.
Rachel, thanks for coming in.